Hi, Meenakshi.
Hi.
I can see that you are sitting beside an altar. So, can you please tell us a little bit about what altar is this?
See, this is a money altar.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I basically talk about three altars that a person should have for all their activities. They should at least have three altars. One is a money altar because money is the survival force of life.
Mm-hmm.
It's really important to have money to do the rest of the things that we want. Another altar should be our ancestor altar, which is really important, which is going to help you to connect to the spiritual world and to do create magic. And another altar which you can have for all the devis and the devtas that you pray to on a daily basis, if you have an altar.
So basically, money altars are made for what? Like, money is, I feel people have a lot of misconception when it comes to money, and it's always a blockage for a lot of people, you know, because...
See, money, there are three steps of money, which I have practiced, which I have learned from, where I have learned from, and that is, one is like attracting, you're attracting the money, the second is maintaining the money, and the third is expanding the money.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for which there are three different steps, there are three different things that we can use. But for which, what I do is, I keep the money altars very active every
mm-hmm.
day.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I have a money altar in my house. I have a money altar in my house which is very close to the entrance of the house.
Mm-hmm.
Like, because we want money to come into the house.
Mm-hmm.
So, I have kept the money altar which is right at the entrance of the house.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I have two money altars in the chamber that I sit in. So,
mm-hmm.
because I think that money is basically money. No one is going to come and give you money without doing any work.
Hmm.
So basically, money is positive energy and money is work energy.
Okay.
So no matter what work you're doing, money is the byproduct of that work.
Hmm.
So when we work so hard, when we are studying or when we are doing kind of our projects and assignments when we do for a long time, we at the end of it, we want the money paid, obviously, for all people.
Right.
So otherwise, there's no point, because you see, sometimes you work hard and then you work harder to
mm-hmm.
get that money back to you, because you're always running behind people to get that money.
Right.
So basically, I'll tell you a few things that you should have in your money altar.
Mm-hmm.
See, you can have, you can create a money bag.
Mm-hmm.
See, there's a money bag here.
Okay.
Which is a golden colored bag. Now,
mm-hmm.
I think that gold is really good for money.
Okay.
And then I have a small tree which somebody had gifted me at some point of time, which is something to do with feng shui. It has got some dollar signs hanging and all that.
Mm-hmm.
It had broken, but still I had kept it.
Okay.
And I have a small bank behind, which has got a, it's a money bank.
Okay.
So there are some, a few change and things like that inside to activate it. I have certain mojo bags which are kept here, which are very old right now, because I created this a few years back, maybe about 4-5 years back. And these, all these mojo bags with different herbs that attract money are there.
Mm-hmm.
I have certain crystals here, very rough crystals, which are like, these are citrine and there's quartz. And under that, if you see, there is another, there's a lot of 10 rupee notes, Indian currency, which is there.
Mm-hmm.
Why do we call notes currency? Because it's energy.
Okay.
So it's like electricity flowing,
mm-hmm.
current.
Mm-hmm.
Then I have a feather here which I had picked up from somewhere. I had one day I had thought about something about money and I got this feather.
Mm-hmm.
So I picked it up and I had kept it. I had some hibiscus over here, which is dried hibiscus, which is there,
mm-hmm.
which is kept here.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a citrine ball here. Citrine
mm-hmm.
basically is there. It's a small globe, but I like citrine because it's a self-cleansing kind of a crystal,
mm-hmm.
which helps in clearing energy as well as drawing money.
Okay.
So, and I always have a, it's a red candle stand. I have some rice inside that, if you can see. There's some rice which is inside that, which is filled up to the brim.
Okay.
And I have this coconut shell candy, which
mm-hmm.
is lit on top. Coconut, again, is a... is a very purified form of an energy.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a money stuff here. Now, this is kept on a box. Basically, we have a lot of boxes which we give in folklore,
mm-hmm.
because a lot of people travel a lot and
mm-hmm.
they like to carry their altars with them.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a tray on top of that. So you can pick up the box from here as well. We
mm-hmm.
energize it for the money attracting thing. And I think it really works wonders for me, and I have seen whoever has bought it and kept it with them has worked wonders for me.
Okay, so by doing, is there any, like, as we know, like in India, we have this thing of, you know, chanting. Is there anything that we need to chant while we, you know, make this box?
No, I don't believe in a lot of chanting for normal people, because you're not attuned to the spiritual world unless you have certain pathway open for you. The chanting doesn't work. So even if you don't want anything, I just think you need to have a clear mind for it. And you should not think about anything negative. Don't focus on the things that you don't have. Like, don't go on saying, I have this problem and I don't have the money and the money is not coming. Even no matter, even if you're following a law of attraction or if you're doing any kind of chanting which is for money, mm-hmm. it will not work unless you put a shutter down to your thoughts, which are like negative thoughts. Keep the cup open. You have to receive the money. So you need to be empty inside to receive the money.
Okay, that was a good information. And are you doing any workshops for this, like where people can come and make their own, you know, altar maybe in front of you?
Yeah, we are planning to have some workshops. It's already, the dates are, you can call up the number, you can call up Folklore for the dates, because we keep having them on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. And definitely you can come and pick up your box. We'll give the box with all the goodies that are required.
Okay.
We'll give candles, we'll give attraction oil, and we'll give some more goodies with it, maybe a key or something to open the door to the other side.
Wonderful. This is something very nice. Looking forward to have more workshops like this. And thank you for all the information, Meenakshi. Thank you.